I'm going to answer that question. Number one, pal, you're not a horseman. Number two, if you aspire to be a horseman, you're going to quit crybabying. You're going to quit being a victim. Horsemen aren't victims. Horsemen are perpetrators. You understand what I'm saying?
Gene, Rick, I know as well as anybody, you guys at Starcade, you and Benoit, that was classic horseman. You two boys played me like a cheap violin. But you know it. I know it. Benoit knows it. You all gave me your best shot, and I still came out the winner. But I want to get back to my question, because Arn, you played second fiddle your whole career to, yes, exactly, to Ole, to Tully, and to this man. So I didn't come to talk to the horse's rear. I came to talk to the lead horse.
Now, Rick, that's not smart. You do not upset Arn Anderson with talk like that.
My goodness, I tell you, Chris Benoit and Nancy are not here. Is Jeff Jarrett getting a tail whipping?
Well, he opened his mouth and to the wrong man. I mean, this guy's the enforcer. He's one of the true horsemen. And I know Jeff Jarrett's trying to campaign to become a horseman, but you've got to get the approval of Arn Anderson.
Now, Flair and Mongo and the lovely Deborah all went to ringside with him, and it seemed as if Deborah likes Jeff Jarrett.
Seems like Deborah likes everybody. But nobody's stopping Arn Anderson either, so you can see where the royalties lie.
Well, the horsemen need to be a tight-knit group. And Jarrett firing back. Look at Jeff Jarrett, if you will. Not backing at all outside. Arn Anderson sends Jarrett in the feet of Mongo with that Halliburton gate. And hit first now to our camera location right near the apron of the ring.
Now look at Flair. I don't know if he's approving of the... He's liking this.
He's liking this fight, and I... Tremendous move by Jarrett. A swinging neck breaker, and he covers Anderson. One, two, three. He beat him. He used the ropes, and he beat him.
Well, you can't beat him. There wasn't a match.
His hand gets raised.
What are you doing? Get him.
We got a big one with members of the Horsemen. And Deborah puts herself in front of Jeff Jarrett.
Don't tell me. That was three. One. I got it away. Come on.
It appears as if she is in the camp of Jeff Jarrett. Mongo is not so sure, but he's protecting his wife. And the argument ensues with Flair and Deborah, as well as Arn Anderson and Jeff Jarrett. We've got horseman problems here.
Well, we got, Flair, the leader of the horsemen, but Mongo McMichael seems to be doing what his wife says.
You're a horseman.
We got a breakdown.
He's a horseman. He's not.
He may not be a horseman, but Deborah certainly doesn't like him, doesn't she? Some jealousy with McMichael and...
I was going to say, if I was McMichael, I'd be all over Jarrett.
Uh-oh. Halliburton's in different hands now.
Wrong hands. Arn would love to flatten that thing.
Flair's going to try to patch things up here. And if they need to patch things up if the horsemen are going to stay a strong force in 1997.
Mongo says he's okay. He's okay with me.
I guess we know who wears the pants in the McMichaels family.
Apparently so. And it was a week ago that... Mongo was saying how that Benoit was letting woman run his life.
Biggest mistake a man can make.
You know, this is amazing. And Arn Anderson still doesn't like it. Jeff Jarrett just pinned Arn Anderson. Yes, he used the ropes, and he's strutting with Ric Flair. I don't think I've ever seen that before in my life. And Arn Anderson, look.
Here's the perfect example.
Arn Anderson just said, to hell with this, and he walked away.
Yeah, you need one leader. Arn Anderson He's been around too long and too full-fledged of a horseman, and I think too proud.
We are seeing the horseman break apart.
And Flair can't control this anymore.
During our very eyes, right before our very eyes, they're breaking apart, and it's because of women. Can you believe that? As strong as the horsemen have been through the years, it has taken women to break them apart.
Hey, it was a face that launched a thousand ships.
I guess so. All right, we're going to take a break here, and we'll try to sort this one out. Coming back with Diamond Dallas and Lord Steven Regal for the television title on a very bizarre first Nitro of 1997.
All she needs to do is gargle with WD-40.